championship morning time.
Championship morning.
All right, we're gonna do our Frisbee competition today. We're really excited about it, so. Anything you gotta say? No? Got nervous?
The nerves are there, but I honestly feel confident this morning.
Yeah. I feel pretty good about this morning too. I think that we're gonna do pretty good, so. Wish us luck. Here we are about to start the competition. We're in Norman, Oklahoma, and we're about to see the first competitors, which is the freestyle competition. So I hope you guys enjoy, and we'll be back.
Time begins. Seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. I'm dreaming it, I'm dreaming it. I'm living big, I'm living big. Don't stop, keep going. Don't stop, keep going. 15 seconds. Time begins.
I'll grab your love, partner. And if you're by yourself, no worries. Just follow after me. Yeah. On to the two-step and cowboy boogie. Grab a sweetheart and spin out.
To the 60 seconds remaining.
To the right. Now take your left hand and put it on your side. Gonna roll your shoulders. Do the slip and slide. This next part's my favorite part of this time to shine. Gonna do the two-step and cowboy boogie. Grab a sweetheart and spin out. Do the fold down and get it. Take it to the left now.
30 seconds remaining.
Slide to the left, slide to the right. Now cool down. Have a good time. Slide to the left, slide to the right.
15 seconds.
Have a good time. Round, round, round.
10.
It's time to show out right now.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
begins. Seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. Seconds. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time begins. Seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. 15 seconds. 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're in my domain, got a crowd screaming out our name. It's a hurricane, it's a before you know it. Why you shaking? We're a dynasty in the making, we're the royal team.
begins. Seconds remaining.
For the distance and accuracy portion, and this is basically what we come to do.
This is what it all comes down to. Two rounds, 60 seconds per round is what it all comes down to. All the training that you've had with your dog comes down to this. Here we go. This is when we really get to express what we love to do the most, right here. Coco gets to compete. We've trained long and hard for it. A lot of windy days, a lot of cold days, a lot of hot days, a lot of two-a-days, three-a-days, four-a-days of her training. It all comes down to these two rounds, 60 seconds per round. And let me just tell you, folks, the wind was blowing out here. The grass was a bit longer than I would like to see on a professional field. We're against the elements here. You know, we're still outdoors, but it was a ride of a lifetime to be able to do this with her, and that's what the training's all about, is getting to show off her skills and really do it up.
Yeah, and you know, Coco got started a lot later in life. She was about 3 years old whenever Mason met me and decided to, you know, teach her Frisbee, and she took to it like a pro. So for us to be able to do these competitions for our first time is huge. So we're...
Yeah, and we've already won one local competition with Coco, mm-hmm. and which was great. And then the year before that, she got third place. So we've been doing it for a little while now.
Just the local ones, not the big one that we just went
to. This was our first out of state. We call it our big time competition.
Yeah.
And they were having some troubles as far as the field goes due to COVID-19, which, you know, some of this is not their fault as far as the grass being mowed. Mm-hmm. You'll hear me say it a few times. I was not particularly happy with the field setup, but, you know, we did do what we can.
Yeah, and they tried their hardest.
They tried their best. We're just happy to be there competing.
This was not their first venue, so they did have to change it up because of COVID. So, but I hope you guys enjoy. Definitely watch, you know, the cool shots that Mason has. And I'm doing the drone work, you know, and the videoing in the background. So,
hope you guys enjoy. Luckily, we were able to put the drone up in the air for this one.
So yep.
Jinny is a very good Frisbee player in perfect conditions. Coco is a great Frisbee player in basically every condition. That's the difference, I think, personally, between some of the performances between them. Jinny definitely got stage fright, and I think she gets anxiety from not being able to herd the other dogs, Coco and Maya. And that's kind of what we saw. But really, that comes down to training, which is our fault. We're still trying to figure out how to coach Jinny into being a better Frisbee dog and minding around people, getting her out in front of people, things like that. So any comments or tips, comment down below. We're still taking in info, doing all of this. this, so.
Yeah, and this is brand new to us, so we want, you know, plenty of comments. If you guys have any thoughts, ideas, anything like that, please comment below. You know, Jinny
is
a great dog.
On how to make Jinny a better Frisbee dog and just better around people. And she's an Australian Shepherd.
Mm-hmm. She's a full Australian Shepherd.
So, but she seems to have a lot of anxiety.
She does, and I've been told that a lot of Australian Shepherds have that. When I was researching, I didn't have a lot of that information, or I guess I didn't see it. When we first got her, I thought they were kind of the same as a Border Collie. That is not true at all. They have some of the same similar qualities. They're really good at herding, but they do have a lot of anxiety. They're very emotional dogs, is what I've been told. So, again, lots of comments. We would love to see the comments. We would love to help our little Jinny out. Such a sweet dog. Okay, so now we're back to Jinny's second try. There was 3 tries total. You're really only supposed to have 2, but when Coco broke from the leash, they gave Jinny a second chance because it was a distraction. So this was her 3rd time going, and it was a little gut-wrenching. It was a little embarrassing. Tell them kind of how you felt, because you were the one really dealing with it.
Yeah, I was worried about it the whole trip. I needed Jinny physically to perform and do this for us. She's been training very well and playing very well. But I knew it was going to be, you know, up to the situation, basically, if she felt right or not to perform. And sure enough, she didn't. And, yeah, it was pretty embarrassing to kind of have to go through it, but ultimately, I would rather go through that and have her experience it than not even try and not get our dogs out at all and not experience it. So that's kind of our whole point with this, is to, you know, just go ahead and get out there and try it. And if you fail, you fail. And it just is what it is.
Yeah, I think honestly, you and I both handled it pretty well. You know, we tried to bring Coco in to see if maybe she would play. We even did a phone call because for some reason, Jinny likes whenever I call or when somebody calls.
Yeah, she recognizes the phone call and she realizes it's, you know, activity. Something is stimulating her besides what's going on. So when other people are around, she usually plays a lot more. But when too many people are around, then she really gets nervous, or when she's in a different environment.
Mm-hmm.
Changing their environments is a big deal as far as their performance goes, or at least for Jinny.
Yeah. And the other thing that she also gets really, like we've talked about before, she gets really anxiety about, or a lot of anxiety about Coco and Maya, because Coco was going off her rocker and breaking the leash,
right,
and doing all of her stuff.
Yeah.
So
she likes to herd her group and
mm-hmm.
make sure her group is there with her, because that's everything to her.
Yeah.
That's what makes her a great dog to have around the fam, because
mm-hmm.
she's always checking on everybody. And
yeah,
and
she does circles around, like when all of our family go to Paladura Canyon, she will make sure that she'll go to the last person and then come all the way back to the front, and she'll do it numerous times. So
oh, yeah.
She definitely
round and round she goes.
Yes. So she's like way more exhausted when she's finished. But anyways, I hope you guys understand a little bit about what happened. Keep enjoying the videos. We'll be back and definitely let you know a little bit more about the story.
Round two, ladies and gentlemen. I know we gotta get points on the board. Me and Coco right here. The pressure is on for us right before this. A lot of dogs have made a lot of big catches. I know we are behind points-wise. I'm trying to get at least top three so we can move on to Chattanooga, Tennessee for world championships. Here we go.
From Arizona, some friends we just met. Anything you want to say real quick before we head out? Oh yeah, absolutely. All right, thank you.
Another comp gone by on us. Coco was not the champion this time, or Jinny. Kind of had some struggles today, but had a good time and happy to be out here. Happy to see a lot of other talented dogs out here. Way more than we've ever seen before, so as far as the talent goes. But yeah, happy to be out here and making a trip of it. Hopefully we'll be back next year to win this thing and qualify for Worlds. Or if we need to hit up another competition to qualify for Worlds as well, then we'll do whatever it takes. But no matter what, we're still proud of our dogs, you know. A lot of it was my fault, not throwing it in the right place, but when it comes down to those 2 rounds of 60 seconds per round, and the whole year of training comes down to that, it really makes it tough on your dog and on you. But that's all part of the experience, you know, and that's what makes this such a great sport. So, really humbled by the experience today. Wish we would have won it. Honestly, I mean, it's no fun to lose a competition, but you know, I'm just glad we're out here doing it. We're happy and healthy. And yeah, thanks all everybody watching out there, you know, and hopefully y'all enjoy the rest of our videos that we got coming. We've got a lot of things planned. This is just the start of what we're gonna take this channel to. So this is just the start. Y'all stay tuned, and we got lots more adventures coming our way.
Okay, so you just saw our last little interview. You know that basically we did not win, but that's okay. You know, we talked about how we definitely were fine, and we had a really great experience and met a lot of really cool people, and we definitely learned a lot, didn't we?
We did. And you can see in the video, I'm a bit bummed there, you know?
Yeah, who's not going to be bummed?
That's just my pride talking, guys. So don't look too far into that. We had a great time out there and learned a lot of great lessons, guys.
We did. So some of the stuff that we're going to have coming up is in our next video would be our anniversary trip to Durango, Silverton area.
Yes, stay tuned for that one, guys, because I'm talking... If you like any of the drone footage in this series, you're going to love Silverton and Durango.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. It is the most gorgeous place. We cannot wait to show you guys this video. Please definitely subscribe to our page if you're interested in watching our stuff. And as always, we always appreciate your support.
Thanks for the support, guys. See y'all in the next one.